Hello there. This video is just a short update to a video that we did tail end of last year, I think October 2017, where we introduced you to the Sky-Watcher AZ-GTi Wi-Fi altazimuth mounting. In that video, I indicated that there were a couple of ideas in the pipeline that were coming through that would allow a little bit of development of the mounting. This video is just to update you on probably the key feature that's come along for this mount. Okay, there are two significant updates that are available to the user of the AZ-GTi. One is quite simple. It's the ability to change the orientation of the telescope in terms of which side of the arm it can be. With the telescope, for example, pointing north is limited. With the new motor control firmware, which has to be downloaded into the mounting, I'm going to tell you about that in a moment, you can actually change that orientation. There's a number of reasons you might want to do that. If you've got a telescope that wasn't specifically supplied for this mount, you may find that the finder is in an uncomfortable position without changing that orientation, but it's a fairly minor detail. The big thing that you can do with the mount, I'm just going to demonstrate it to you very easily. We do this, and then we do this. Bingo, an equatorial mount, just by adding a little bit of off-the-peg hardware. Now, you can achieve some of this simply with a tripod that's got the right kind of tilt on it. This isn't included with the mounting or anything like that. There's no upgrade package that you can buy. This EQ1 counterbalance shaft and weight, I actually got this from our good friends at Astroboot. They seem to have a bottomless pit of this kind of stuff that you can get there. This, you can use the Star Adventurer, little Star Adventurer Mini, and the Star Adventurer, of course, can have a little wedge with them, and you can use this little mounting to achieve exactly what I've done here. But there's a number of ways you can solve the tilt issue, but you are kind of on your own with it in terms of how you do that. Most important of all, you've got to update the firmware in the AZ-GTi head. This has to be done across a Wi-Fi network to achieve this. And big point here, government warning, this new firmware isn't a formal copy of the firmware. Skywatcher, to a certain degree, are choosing not to give it a formal version number. And they're basically putting it out there as a kind of trial to see if people are interested and to take things a little bit further. If you downloaded this firmware and put it in here, you'd have to know you're flying without a parachute. You can't necessarily expect full and proper support for it. Okay, they've actually warned all users of that on their website. What's my view of that? Well, I suppose maybe this is a fairly modest advance in the performance of this, but I can see that it would be of interest to some people. You're going to get some benefits here in terms of pointing accuracy. They'll be quite small, but you will get them. And also the tracking performance of the mounting is likely to be improved. Just think about it. With the normal AZ system, you have two motors operational. You're taking one of those motors away completely, so you're probably halving the accumulated errors over time. That fact alone is also going to cannon on to an improvement in the over time pointing accuracy as well, because those errors accumulate gradually over time. The mounting's idea of what the sky is doing and what the sky is really doing begins to diverge over time. The equatorial version enablement of this mount is likely to keep that gap to the absolute minimum. Is that really worth taking the risk of putting firmware? Well, only you can really answer that and decide whether or not you think upgrading the firmware is an easy task for you or whether it's a step too far. But you do need to remember, you'd need to do it over a Wi-Fi network. You'll need to download the firmware loader and also the firmware itself. Good news, you can always go backwards. There is the existing firmware is available on the website as well. It's got a little bug fix in it, so you needn't really panic too much. You could immediately take off this new firmware and go back to the last authorized version. But remember, that won't have the equatorial mount mode. The way this works is actually quite simple. Now, to get this running, you'll need to go to skywatcher.com. You'll need to go to their support page up here, right along the top of the screen. You can see this support. Drop into that, go down to software and firmware, take a look at motor controllers. So come down onto this menu and look at motor controllers. And we need the motor controller firmware loader for Wi-Fi version 1.69. So we need that. And then further down, you can see the standard firmware version 3.1. Sorry, I think I got that wrong earlier. I think I said it was 3.31. It's actually 3.1. And the one that I've been talking to you about, the one that you're going to need to get the right arm and the AZ EQ dual mode functionality is this unnumbered firmware version that you see here. You can just download that to your PC. You'll need to then log on to the Wi-Fi mount via its Wi-Fi system, and you'll need to send this file via the motor controller loader via your Wi-Fi system. You'll need to have the pro version of the SynScan app. This is a newer version to the one that we originally recommended for the AZ-GTi last year. This has got the features that you need, and before you get to this point, when you first fire it up, when the mount is actually running, you will be offered a choice. You'll be offered whether you want to operate the mount in Altaz mode or in Equatorial mode, and it's simply a question of selecting the mode that you need, and then all the other features are available to you. So just a very quick recap on what we've been talking about. The software requirements to be able you to use your AZ-GTi in Equatorial mode, there are basically three elements to it. You'll need to be using the new version of the SynScan app, that's SynScan Pro. You need to be using the Pro version to have this functionality. You'll also need those two files that I showed you. That's the uploader to enable you to transfer the firmware to the motor firmware, new motor firmware to the AZ-GTi, and you'll need the file itself. There's full documentation and support with that, those software files. The general principle is quite straightforward though. You'll need to disconnect your PC's Ethernet cable, and you'll need to log in to the Wi-Fi system that the AZ-GTi is putting out. So you need to make a direct wireless connection between your PC and the AZ-GTi so that you can then transfer the new motor firmware across that Wi-Fi link. So do bear that in mind. Just to repeat, that software, that new firmware is not a formal version. You can't expect support. Certainly don't call me if it goes wrong. I'm warning you now that there is no support guaranteed from SkyWatcher. You might begin to see more and more people doing this on the forums and spotting the bugs with it or what isn't working properly. Hardware requirements, as I've already shown you, are quite straightforward. You need some method of tilting the AZ-GTi to get your polar alignment to line it up, and you'll also want some kind of method of offsetting some of the imbalance of the system by putting a counterbalance shaft in here and maybe some kind of weight. It's the kind of thing you can bodge up. The thread in here is M12. You can get counterbalance shafts quite easy from vendors like Astroboot. They seem to have a bottomless pit of this kind of junk, and you'll probably be able to get a weight there as well, so that shouldn't be insurmountable. You can come across photographic tripods that will enable you to do this tilt as well sometimes. There are quite a few professional grade tripods that would allow for this kind of thing. I'm seeing this more as a photographic opportunity, so a camera and lens. I'm thinking that that's the most worthwhile part if you're going to use this as a traveling mount of some kind. Anyway, you've seen it here. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye for now.